So, good old peeps, it's dark, it's 20 over 8 in Denmark, that means it's really, really dark in winter. And I was just booting into my good old little OpenSUSE Tumbleweed system here with the good old geckos having fun and wanted to upgrade it and mess around. And it's like second prototype, advanced APALP, it's kind of their newer version of OpenSUSE that's going to take over Leap and probably also going to be the base of SUSE Enterprise Linux, or SUSE Linux Enterprise, whatever it gets called nowadays. So I went in here and I read, you know, this little article here, and it's really, really interesting. One thing that really, really dropped into my my brain: they're going to utilize TPM. Linux is embracing TPM. So the Manteau Mountainous prototype has the big addition of full disk encryption. So now my full disk encryption people would be amazingly glad for that. ALP, or Advanced Linux Platform, or Adaptable Linux Platform, extend this full disk encryption to bare metal servers. And the use of a trusted platform module will open the doors to leverage unintended booting while keeping systems encrypted and secure. ALP is intended to run both private and public clouds that require encryption features. So if you are one of those people that think that ALP is going to be, oh, this is a Linux desktop, no, this is meant for the clouds, this is a cloud technology. But they are going to embrace or utilize TPM, which, if we go and Google it, it's used for digital rights management, Windows Defender, blah, 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 software license, protect enforcement of software licenses, and prevent cheating in online games. Its developer is Microsoft. It's BSD license. So if you're an open source fanatic, you should love TPM. It's under the BSD license. It's done by Microsoft, but it's open source, and you can see the source code of it here. Soon, I would suspect Red Hat and Fedora will follow suit. Maybe even Debian. Maybe even Ubuntu. Soon, TPM would be stable in the Linux community, and you will see a lot of Linux YouTuber and Linux people praising TPM's security effort. Like, Linux is now on the forefront of security. Linux is trying to be more secure and using TPM to help you be more secure, and so on and so on and so on. They are now going to spin this in a positive way, because what it does is add security. Trust me, you will start to see a lot of Linux fanboys spinning this in a positive way in the name of security. They didn't really do that for Windows 11. Now Linux is starting to embrace the TPM, because it's, you know, more and more computers are starting to have TPM modules in them. And it would be foolsome to not utilizing, you know, a module that helps you be more secure. Of course, it will, I hope it will be an option under Linux that you don't need TPM, that it's an option you can use to, you know, advance your security. So if you see some of these people starting to embrace TPM, but didn't embrace it when Windows 11 came out, you have my permission to run up to them and take a really, really dirty, moldy sandwich and smack it in their face and call them a hypocrite and run away. I just found this really, really funny. Interesting read. SUSE keeps making a lot of great technologies, the same with OpenSUSE. See you all later. Have an amazing day. Bye-bye.